Today we are making some cornbread on the top of the little wood burning stove. I went ahead and put a quarter of a cup of, it sounds like a lot, calm down, a quarter of a cup of oil, a quarter of a cup of milk, and we are going to have 1 cup of meal. Cornmeal, 1/3 cup, that's self-rising flour, and 1/4 cup, that sounds like a lot again, 1/4 cup sugar. This is not diet food, this is high energy, high calorie food. That's what we're trying to make here. It needs to taste good, but it needs to, you know, when we eat it, we need to, we're not on a diet out in the woods, okay? Or in a survival situation, you get each chew you want it to count. And then we're going to put a healthy pinch, 1/4 teaspoon of salt, because you need it. Then we're going to shoot the cat. There's something on here that, or something that goes in here that I don't have in here. I have to go get it here in a second, and I'll take y'all with me for that. But it's pretty simple. You add this stuff. Now, I pre-measured all this. I didn't have to try to do it out here. Well, except for the salt. This is just water. Put a little bit in there to get her started. You just mix this up. You don't want it to be liquid the first time you do it. You want it to get lumpy. You want it to be kind of thick. You want to, this will allow you to make sure that everything, the sugar, the salt, the milk, the oil, everything's reasonably evenly dispersed in here. We're not in a race, so we can leave this set a minute. So let's go get the other ingredient. This is my stash pile. That's a chicken. Let's see if she'll bite me for this. Ouch. 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 Let's try one of these. It is important, though, when you're doing something like that, to break this egg into something other than what you're cooking, because it could be gross. Ah, lucky on the first try. Nothing wrong with that one. That's all we need. I'm not putting that one back. I'll eat it later. Put the egg in there and we'll mix that up. See, when we left to get the egg, we weren't gone 60 seconds. It's literally right out the back door. But that stuff had already firmed up. The self-rising flour had already started to swell a little bit. Cornmeal had absorbed a little moisture. You can add more sugar, you can put honey, you can put a little butter. I caution people against putting butter though, because butter can scorch at high temperatures, and temperature control on a wood burning stove is often not the simplest task. And on how much water I put in there, yep, about that much. That's on you. You're going to have to figure that out yourself. Now, I'm not oiling this pan because there should be ample oil in the dough or mix or whatever you want to call it. Then we will just put this in this. Yes, it's an aluminum pan. We're all going to die. in this aluminum pan. And again, we're not in a race here. We can let that set a minute while we get everything else ready, which it's pretty much. This, because there's no cover for this, again, we have to improvise. Y'all have been with me before when I've done this. We will put this on there, get it started cooking, and then we will actually cover the bread with something to form an oven. One thing I don't have, Bitty Boo showed it on her channel, it's a little riser. It's a way to keep it from having direct contact with the stove so the bottom doesn't scorch. I've got a minute before I have to worry about that. So we're going to go and get it started. And I'll go on a hunt, see if I can find something to make work. Actually found something reasonably quick. Lighting's warm. Keep standing in front of my light. Did I mention it's dark and cold outside? This is the bottom to one of my fire starting tins that I use. It had my char wood in it, but that's okay. We can use it. Now I have to go find something to cover it with. Sure hope I don't have to go too far. I had to trek over the Himalayan mountains and across the Andes Sea. Wait, that's Andes mountains too. Never mind. Whatever. I had to go to the kitchen and get this. Boom. Cooking with natural gas. Well, nah, actually that's cooking with wood. But whatever. Yeah. That's my $8 whatever. Stew pot. Pretty cool. My daughter got me a little pot that's under there making the cornbread. That's pretty cool. I don't have anything that people have given me that I haven't used to pieces. I'm that guy, I use something until it breaks and then I hold on to it for forever. I'm like, I gotta fix that. Such and such gave it to me. And I think sooner or later the missus like puts it in the garbage. But hey. That's life. That's gonna cook. It's gonna take a little while I get into that right there. See that right there? That's coffee. You can smell it here. Y'all can't smell it there, but I can smell it right there. So while y'all sit here for an hour and watch that cook, I'm gonna drink coffee. We can fast forward through all that. If it looks like I turned this camera off, yeah, I didn't. I'm literally going to let it fast forward or record the whole cooking time. I'm just going to fast forward through it. Okay? Okay. And I have some oceanfront property in Arizona too, by the way.
Y'all read that? It says believe. There's a little Sasquatch on there. But I'm going to say that you should read it and put yourself behind it. Believe in yourself. Put yourself behind believing in yourself. believe in yourself and get it done. Tell you what, you get a good fire in the cook stove and ain't no shortage of warm. It's 37 degrees outside. Already down on my t-shirt in here. Y'all people, this side note for all you intelligent folks out there, this I'm gonna run out in the woods and cook on my wood stove in my little cabin and all that stuff. You ain't gonna do that in the summertime. It's miserable cooking on a campfire in the summer. I don't want to think about that. I got a couple little ditties around here that I'm really fond of, the little propane cookers. And, I'm going to use them until I have to use something else. This is fun, man. I prefer to do it this way, but I do it this way because it's when I want to. Does that make any sense? Not every day because I have to. You'll see. It ain't ready yet. Been about 10 minutes. I see that. Ooh, can y'all smell that? Here's some more of that we all gonna die stuff. Found a can of Campbell's Chunky Vegetable Beef Stew. Beef with country vegetables. Stew. When I was cleaning up a while ago. It says Best Buy August 13th. 2018. It's dirty. I didn't wash it. I'm gonna cook it in aluminum. It's past its best buy date. I'm cooking it in aluminum and pouring it out of a dirty can. And didn't wash my hands either. It's nice knowing y'all. Check it. Cornbread. If it's browning on top, I need to do something different. Yeah, I don't pan it. I won't die of smoke inhalation or nothing. I don't pan it. Not this one. Y'all do recognize my little pan there, don't you? Leave that over right here. I put the handles on top that time. Now we give it a little breathing room. That'll heat the top of that bread up, cause it to brown a little bit. Maybe, if we do it right.
It's been about 5 minutes.
Looks like. I guarantee you that little pan or that big pie pan is hot now. Good enough for the gals I run with. Which, pretty high class ladies. Let's get that off there. There's bread. Now let's wait for stew. See how this turned out. Yeah, it's stuck to the aluminum. That's okay. We'll spoon it out if we have to. Here's your cornbread. We're gonna put some butter on there. We're gonna eat it.
Give me all the stuff about the lighting. Stew. Cornbread. Yada yada. There's stews out of a can. But I made the cornbread. Like I say, just do it. I mean, what's the worst thing that could happen if you try something? You don't get it right the first time, or the second time, or the third time. I didn't always know how to make cornbread in a bucket. Something I learned how to do. It'd be pretty good if they had to put a celery in it. Probably a nice celery. Show you know that. That's a butter. Cornbread. This is what y'all waiting on anyway. Tell y'all a little trick. Y'all can take this butter and y'all can melt it. And pour some of that molasses in there. That'd be a dipping sauce for the cornbread. Just sweet enough. It's not so sweet that it tastes like cake. But you can tell it's sweet. I mentioned the last. Oh, I should open this off again. Now I'm gonna look like a weak man. I have to give up my man card. My wife has a problem with molasses. She says it's too strong. And it is. It's got pretty good. It's got a pretty cool strong flavor to it. But that's okay. We like the strong flavors.
Now that ought to be illegal right there. If you ain't never tried no molasses on your cornbread, a little bit of butter. I feel bad for you. Because your life is not complete. No, still out. Don't die.
I won't sit here and get fat.